develop survey items to measure employee digital literacy. Coming up with survey items to measure something could take quite some time. Say I want to measure employee satisfaction at a TV program production company using a survey. Typically, one would need to do quite a bit of literature research first, looking for a validated scale adapted to fit the specific industry and organizational context in order to create the survey instrument. And if one cannot directly find a previously published scale for the specific concept that they are trying to measure, they would need to create the survey items on the basis of literature and theory about that concept in order to construct the survey to measure it. But with ChatGPT, we could just directly ask. Let's look at three examples. First, we want a survey to measure employee satisfaction at a TV program production company. So we will prompt, create survey items to measure employee satisfaction at a TV program production company. And here we go. These items are pretty solid, covering key factors and dimensions of job satisfaction. So let's have this converted into a full survey. So we prompt, now develop the survey in full using these items. Clearly, the formatting can use some adjustments and improvements, but overall, it is a solid start for constructing the final survey. Let's now ask for the sources for the survey items. What are the sources on which you based your survey items? So it gives a general answer. Let's prompt again, asking for a specific source. We prompt, give one specific source, and we want the source in APA format. This source is a website, so we prompt again, provide another source which is not a website. It gives the Robinson Judge book, which we actually used in our teaching. Notice, without me asking this time, it already puts this source in APA. Let's ask for another source, which is not a book nor a website. So it gives a research paper. Good enough. Let's try another example, focusing on leadership styles this time. We prompt, what main leadership styles are there? It returns six leadership styles, autocratic leadership, transformational leadership, servant leadership, laissez-faire leadership, transactional leadership, and charismatic leadership style. So we stick with these six. I prompt, create survey items to measure these six leadership styles. It comes up with two items per leadership style, but I want three, so I prompt again, create three items per leadership style. Here we go, three items per leadership style. Let's now ask for the sources so we can use exactly the same prompts as we used before. What are the sources on which you based these leadership style survey items? It gives four sources, so we prompt. The four sources you provided, put them in APA format, which it does, but we prompt again. Provide another specific source, which is not a textbook, but clearly this is a textbook, so let's prompt again. Provide one more specific source, which is not a textbook. But again, this is still a book, so we prompt yet again. Provide one more specific source, which is a research paper. Good, this is fine. Let's prompt one more time. Provide one more specific source, which is a research paper. Good, that's enough for now. Finally, we ask for survey items to measure employee digital literacy. So I first prompt, what is digital literacy? Just to make sure we're on the same page. And then we prompt, develop survey items to measure employee digital literacy. Again, it does a pretty good job. Items all seem to be in line with literature and theory. If we need to, we could again ask for sources using the same prompts we used earlier. But I'm going to skip that for now. In conclusion, ChatGPT does a nice job creating survey items. Now, you might say the job satisfaction measure, if you just Google it, you can probably find one quite easily. That is indeed the case. But the scales for leadership styles and employee digital literacy, these scales are typically not freely available. It is true, if I carefully Google for a while and try many different sites, I might eventually find a free version somewhere, but that's going to take quite some time and effort. With ChatGPT, however, we get it within a minute or so. Look, here are some of the scales and measures that I have saved here on my home computer, and I have even more on my school drive. I save them because I know how time-consuming it is trying to locate the right scale and items when you need them. With ChatGPT and other AI tools, getting the right survey items becomes easier. And this could be quite helpful to students and researchers. All right, that's it for this video. Please leave your thoughts and comments down below. Thanks for watching this Ranywayz random video. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.